क्लास 9 बायोलॉजी। गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे विल स्टार्ट चैप्टर 11 डाइजेस्टिव सिस्टम। बट इन द गूगल मीट वी हैव डिस्कस सम ऑफ द टॉपिक्स, दैट इज व्हाई द नीड फॉर अ डाइजेस्टिव सिस्टम, बिकॉज डाइजेस्टिव सिस्टम कन्वर्ट कॉम्प्लेक्स फूड स्टफ इनटू देयर सिंपलर डिफ्यूजेबल फॉर्म सो दैट कैन बी एब्जॉर्ब बाय द वॉल ऑफ द एलिमेंट्री कैनन फॉर देयर ट्रांसपोर्टेशन टू ईच एंड एवरी पार्ट्स ऑफ द बॉडी। दिस डाइजेस्टिव सिस्टम कॉन्सिस्ट ऑफ टू पार्ट, the alimentary canal and the associated digestive gland. Alimentary canal is a long muscular tube that starts from the mouth and ends at the anus. It is about 9 meters long and highly coiled, especially in the small intestinal region. Its various regions are different both in structure and function. Some are wide, some part is highly constricted. This alimentary canal, when associated with the digestive gland, for example, salivary gland in the mouth region, gastric gland in the stomach, pancreas, liver. So when the digestive gland associated with the alimentary canal, it is called digestive system. Once more, when the associated digestive gland associated with the alimentary canal, it is called digestive system that help in the process of digestion. The digestion begins always at the mouth. This mouth contains various structure or parts like teeth, tongue, and the secretion from the salivary gland. The mouth or the oral cavity is a space where the food is chewed and mixed with the saliva. So food is chewed and mixed with the saliva. It is carried out by the teeth and the tongue. Teeth cut the food into smaller particles and tongue used to manipulate the food. When it manipulates the food, it is properly mixed with the saliva. The saliva acts on the food. Its front limits means its opening, the opening of the buccal cavity, are formed by two lips, that are upper lip and the lower lip. The lips help in closing the mouth while eating. Sucking and sipping liquid, speaking, and also in perceiving certain sensations, especially those of touch and heat. So these are the functions of lips. A muscular tongue help in manipulating the food while chewing and mixing it with the saliva. Swallowing, tasting, clearing the food particles from the teeth after eating, and also in speaking. Clear? Now teeth, dentition. The teeth have a very special role. They cut and break the food into smaller bits. The small size bits have a relatively larger surface area. See it here, This is one food particle. It has certain it has certain surface area, only this much. But if we cut this food particle into several smaller particles, then the surface area will increase enormously. So that it is helpful for the saliva to act on each food particles for their easy digestion. That's why we chew the food, or it is always advised to chew the food properly before swallowing. The teeth also help in speaking. The teeth also add to the facial beauty. So think about your face without teeth. Now, an adult human have 32 teeth. 32. These teeth are different in shape and perform different functions. So the different types of teeth are incisor for cutting and biting. Cutting and biting. Canine, tearing, especially flesh. That's why carnivores have long pointed canines. Premolars. And molars. These are grinding or crushing teeth. Means it crushes the food into very small particles so that the food change into a circular mass called bolus. So see the shape. Cutting canine having projections, hill like projections. So incisors are the four front teeth in the center of each jaw. Their cutting is broad and sharp like a chisel. They are used for biting and cutting. Canines are one on either side of the incisors in each jaw. These are conical and sharply pointed for holding and tearing the food. Premolars are two on each side on each jaw next to the canines. Each premolar has two hill-like projections or cusps on its surface, hence known as bicuspid. Two cusps, two roots. Premolars help in grinding and crushing the food. Once more, it is bicuspid, means two roots. So here, see, molars are the last three teeth on each side in each jaw. They have a larger surface than the premolars. They are the principal grinders and crushers of food. The last molar of each side in each jaw is called the wisdom teeth, because this last teeth appears at an age of 18-19 or more. The wisdom teeth also called, because they appear last on the age of 17 to 20 years when the human body is reaching maturity. Now see the setup. This is the upper lip, lower lip. We can say that upper lip is the mirror image of the lower lip. Clear? And this part, one half, will be the mirror image of the other. Now see the position of teeth in one part. So here, two incisor, one canine, two premolar, and three molar. So how much in one side? 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Altogether 8 teeth. What I said? This part will be the mirror image of this part. So similar way, here it will be 2 incisor, 1 canine, 2 premolar, and 3 molar. Then one row, it will be 16. Means 4 incisor. Incisor will be 4, canines will be 2, premolars will be 4, and molars will be 6. 6, 4, 10, 12, 16. The upper lip will be upper lip or upper dentition will be the mirror image of this one. So on this basis, dental formula is find out. So the dental formula of adult will be how much? Incisor 2, canines 1, premolars 2, molars 3. On the upper lip side, again it is the same. So it is the dental formula of the adult. If it is in the adolescents, then instead of 3 molar, means in adolescent no wisdom teeth appear, so here 2 incisor, 1 canine, 2 premolar, and 2 molar. So number of teeth here 32, here 28, and in child 212, no molar teeth, 212, so only 20. So this is the dental formula of adult, adolescent, and the child. Clear? Now see, the human or mammalian teeth, are different in shape and are called heterodont. So as opposed to homodont, teeth of other animals such as lizard and frog. Lizard and frogs have similar teeth. So the type of teeth is said to be homodont. Now see, mammalian teeth appear in two sets during life. In human, the first set or milk teeth consists of 20 teeth that start growing through the gums when the child is about 7 to 8 months old and are completed when he is about 2 years old. These temporary or milk teeth or deciduous teeth fall out result of their roots being dissolved away in the jaw and are completely replaced by the permanent teeth by about 12 years of age. So number of permanent teeth of mammal is usually indicated in a formula that I have discussed. That is the dental formula. So the human teeth is diphyodont, two sets of teeth, and it is heterodont because we have different shapes of teeth. In the next session, we will study the structure of a tooth. Okay. Have a good day.